ইন্দ্রিয়া বিফল তৎপরা সংযত ইন্দ্রিয়া আর রেজাল্ট অফ নলেজ ইজ দ্যাট ওয়ান টু বি রেস্ট্রেইন ইন দি ম্যাটার অফ সেন্স জাজমেন্ট ইউ ক্যানট বিকাম প্রগ্রেসিভ ইন স্পিরিচুয়াল লাইফ ইফ ইউ ইন্ডালজ ইন আনরেস্ট্রিক্টেড সেন্স গ্র্যাটিফিকেশন বিকজ সেন্স গ্র্যাটিফিকেশন ইজ দি কজ অফ আওয়ার বন্ডেজ ইন দিস ম্যাটেরিয়াল ওয়ার্ল্ড অ্যান্ড দ্য হোল ট্রিটমেন্ট প্রগ্রেসিভ ইন স্পিরিচুয়াল লাইফ দিস রেগুলেটেড of course we have got senses and the senses require some satisfaction that is all right there is no question of stopping these senses it is not possible if you want to stop the work of the senses that is not possible simply we have to purify the senses Just like when you are diseased, your senses are under certain symptoms of the disease. Just like I am feeling the tongue, whatever I am eating, the tongue is tasting bitter. Bitter. That is a symptom of my disease. So, we haven't got to cut this tongue altogether, but we have to make treatment so that we can taste proper. There is practical example. One who is suffering from jaundice, if you give him something sweet, sugar candy, he will taste it bitter. Although sugar candy is not bitter. But due to his illness, due to his jaundice disease, he can make a practical taste of it. But at the same time, that sugar candy is the medicine for jaundice. If a man is suffering from jaundice, if you simply give him water of sugar candy, you just moisten sugar candy at night, and just early in the morning you take a glass of sugar candy water, within very short time you will be cured from jaundice disease. Similarly, this restriction do not, when we make spiritual life progressive, there are certain restrictions and they may seem at the present stage, very bitter, but that is the way you have to accept that it is called Sanghitindri. And if we can make progress in that way, restraint sense gratification and following the rules and regulations, then we are sure to acquire the knowledge. Labdha-jnanam param shanti, and when you are situated in that perfectional stage of knowledge, then you get param shanti, perfect peacefulness of mind. Param shanti, rivatsati. Now, these are the prescriptions laid down by Krishna, Lord Krishna. So he must have faith in Krishna. Krishna is not an ordinary man like me. I am speaking not from my own account. I am speaking on account of Krishna. So, Krishna is accepted as the supreme authority by great scholars, great philosophers, religionists, and if you have any respect for Indian spiritual culture is knowing that in India, whatever sect they may be, there are many sects, but every one, each and every one, all sects, including the Mohammedans, they have got great respect for Krishna. Now, the Krishna Janmashtami is just approaching on the 8th September. The birthday of Krishna will be observed in India. And probably we may also make a program for observing the birthday ceremony here. So you will find that just like in your country, in Christmas Day, we all observe the birthday of Lord Christ. Similarly, Krishna, the birthday of Krishna will be observed in India, 10% people. So Krishna is a great authority, undoubtedly, that is accepted. So here, Krishna gives us a prescription. And if we try to follow, then surely we shall achieve the stage of perfect knowledge, and the result will be that we shall be the perfectly peaceful in life. The Bhuttan Gandhidharasam Sadhguru Mahasaram, that is the perfect knowledge. And we understand that the Supreme Lord, He is the Supreme Enjoyer. Bhuttan Gandhidharasam Sadhguru Mahasaram, He is the Supreme Proprietor. And if we think very, pretty nicely, with real help, then we can understand that everything, whatever there is in our presence, the actual proprietor is God or Krishna. We are not proprietors. We have got the right to use them. The things which are given by God to us, we shall have the right to use them. But we are not proprietors. He is put into the wilderness of this material world. Now, what is that wilderness? There are 8 million and 400,000 of different species of life. Now, if we miss this opportunity, the human form of life, it is the developed forms of life. And if you miss the opportunity, then you shall be again thrown into the cycle of birth and death in that 8,400,000 species of life. That is somebody. Vinasthapa means, where you shall be put up. There is no strategy. So you must make properly to the so one who has got faith, what he may be stated, Nayam Lutasthi Matara, Na Sukham Anasarasana. Anyone who has no faith, for him, there is no profit even in living this life and what to speak of in the next life. Yoga Sannastha Karmanam, ज्ञानसंशयम आसदंत न कर्माणि निवर्जन्ते धनंजय से धनंजय अद्य anyone who is working in the Krishna consciousness of yoga. Yoga means God conscious or Krishna conscious. Anything, any attempt which you perform, which you do for spiritual realization is called yoga. Yoga. So there are many different kinds of yoga, but they have been divided into three: the Jnana Yoga, Karma Yoga, and Bhakti Yoga. Jnana Yoga means realization of self by cultural philosophical discussion. That is called Jnana Yoga. And Dhyana Yoga and Karma Yoga. Karma Yoga means that the ordinary persons who are engaged in working, that we have got experience that these people in New York City, they are working day and night. And karma means work and give some profit. That is called karma. Karma, nobody is going to work without any remuneration. Everyone is working for getting some profit. That is called karma. But that ordinary karma and karma yoga is different. You can engage yourself in ordinary work, but at the same time, you can become a yogi. How that is possible? When your consciousness is changed. Your consciousness now and thinking that I am working for my maintenance or for my family maintenance or for my society's maintenance or for my country's maintenance, becomes vast, widening, even if it is not for international maintenance. It still, it is not perfect. Even if you work for the whole planetary system, that is imperfect. But when you work for Krishna consciousness, that is the most perfect. So you have to work with Krishna consciousness. That is the perfect. Just like several times I have discussed this point, that a big tree, if you have to pour water, then you have to pour water on the roof. The tree has millions and billions of leaves, and if you go on pouring water on each and every leaf, neither will be able to pour water to all the leaves, neither it is possible to maintain the tree by pouring water on the leaf. You have to pour water on the roof. Similarly, our work, our endeavor, whatever we must do, good work or bad work, if it is not done on account of Krishna, then that will remain always imperfect. Always. Therefore it is advised, yoga samnasya karmanam. You just give up your work, or place your working capacity, energy. We have got some energy. We work, or we do anything, is our energy. So spiritual self-realization means that energy should be transferred for Krishna or God. Energy. We have got some stock of energy. That energy should be transferred. You can transfer that energy in so many ways. In whatever way you can do it, it doesn't matter. You have to transfer your energy for Krishna. just like Arjun. Arjun was a military man. He had the energy to fight. So he fought for Krishna. That means he engaged his energy for Krishna. He did not change his military position. So we have to change our position. Simply, we have to transfer the energy for Krishna. So that is called yoga sannyasa karmanam. Not that we cease to work. Work enough. Without work, then nothing can be done. But if you share your energy in that way, for Krishna's work, then yoga sannyasa karmanam, Jnana Samchinna Samshaya. And in that position, why I shall engage my energy in Krishna, that requires knowledge. That is real knowledge. So why? Why I shall? Because you are a part and parcel of Krishna. Therefore you are meant for, your energy is for Krishna. Nothing else. Several times I discussed this fact that this hand, this work of my hand, is a kind of energy of my body. Now this hand is meant for working for this body. Similarly, Manimansa, Jivarhita, Jivarhita, Sanatana, the living entities, they are all parts and parcels of the Supreme, and therefore the energy, that energy also part and parcel, that energy was a part of Krishna. Krishna has got unlimited energy, and our energy is just a part of energy, that's the part of energy. Therefore our energy should be spent for Krishna. Jnana Samchinna Samshaya, and that utilizing the energy for Krishna should be based on pure knowledge. Pure knowledge. That how, what is that pure knowledge? That I am meant for Krishna, or I am meant for God. So I should utilize my energy for that purpose. Apavantam nakarmani nirajnandi dharanja. So anyone who is working in this way, then he hasn't got to suffer the consequent need of that of any work. He is free from the reaction of this world. Tasmat jnana samhitam hristam jnana jnana sinat manaha chitta ina samsayam jirgam atitta uttitta bharata. So, Arjuna was declining to fight. Now, Krishna is advising him that now you can take up your path for fighting. Tasmat jnana samhitam hristam, because I have spoken to you the mode of working, your energy, and you are fighting not for yourself, but you are fighting for my account. Therefore, you have nothing to doubt. You can break up and just stop. Then Arjuna says, sannyasam karmanam krishna punarjivanta samsati jatshaya itara ritam tanme bruhi samskritam. Krishna says, Arjuna says, my dear Krishna, that you have now spoken about the sannyasam. Sannyasam means to give up the reaction of all work. Then again, you are asking me to work. Sannyasam karmanam krishna. Then you are speaking of this yoga. karma yoga. So, that is quite possible. When the spiritual master instructs to the disciple on different subject matter, sometimes the disciple becomes puzzled, which of them has to be accepted and which has to be carried and which has to be rejected. In the beginning, such puzzling things appear. So, it is appearing to Krishna, to Arjuna, that Krishna has spoken to him on various subjects about sannyas. Sannyas means renounce, just as we are in sannyas. This is called renounce order of life. And in the Vedic system, there are four divisions of social order: brahmachari, grihastha, vanaprastha, and sannyas. Brahmachari means from the beginning of, from 5 years to 25 years, one has to live in the house of the spiritual master for being trained. That is called brahmachari. And after one has full training, then he comes home and he gets himself married. That is called grihastha, or householder. Then, after the age of 15 years, he lives the gifts of the family, not exactly gifts of family kind of thing, but tries to remain aloof from the family. So the husband and wife, they interest in the whole thing to the grown-up boys, they go out of home and travel in so many holy places. And after traveling for 6 months, again come home, so I remain for 1 month, and then again go away. That is the, that stage is called vanaprastha. Then when the man is completely detached from family at the time, he takes him now. This is called sannyas. We have no connection with family. So sannyasam karmanam krishna punarjodanta sansi. So these things have been discussed in the previous chapter. So Arjuna says that we are talking so many subject matter, so there are so many doubts arising in my mind. So kindly, just shriya rita ritam. So out of so many things, shriya is the best process. Kindly speak to me that one with passion. This is called Parikrishna. The spiritual master is speaking and the disciple is hearing. So as soon as there are some doubts and puzzling, so you should at once place the matter before the spiritual master to get it clear. So this is the process which Arjuna is following. So he has heard, and after 4 chapters so many things, now he has got some doubt. He is placing before Krishna and asking him, out of so many things, please let me know which of them is exactly I have to say. Now the Bhagavan was Krishna. Bhagavan means there are definitions. There is definition of Bhagavan. Bhagavan means the personality of God. And he is God. That is described in the Vedic literature. Aishabhyasya samadrasya vidyasya jasasasriya jnana vairagyasriya sarayati bhagavan. Aishabhya is an opulence. Aishabhya is a samadrasya, entire opulence. Aishabhya is a samadrasya vidyasya. Vidyasya means strength, entire strength. And jasa, jasa means fame, the entire fame. Jasa is a sriya. Sriya means, sri means beauty. entire beauty. That is jnana, the jnana means knowledge, entire knowledge. And vairagya, entire renunciation. These things, whenever we find, wherever we find, in complete, he is there. This six items, entire opulence, entire strength, entire fame, entire beauty, entire knowledge, and entire demand. Six. Sarayati bhavana. So, if you are searching after God, so here is the definition of God. He just applies this definition, and when you find that here is the perfect application of these six things, then he is God. So, entire opulence, there are many rich men in New York City, but nobody can say that I am the proprietor. In fact, I am the proprietor of the entire bank balance. Nobody can. Similarly, entire strength, entire fame, entire knowledge. Now, so far, the Bhagavad Gita is concerned, you will find the entire knowledge in it. If you study Bhagavad Gita, of course, so far, entire opulence, entire strength, when Krishna was present, he showed it. That is stated in the history and the Mahabharata, in the Srimad Bhagavatam, and many other Vedic literature, they are stated. So, suppose you do not believe that, they have been written so many things for Krishna, just to make him very great. You may not believe that. But at least you have got in your presence one thing, this Bhagavad Gita. This is spoken by Krishna, and you will find here entire knowledge. Entire knowledge. Any knowledge of the world, any knowledge, even material, spiritual, political, scientific, philosophical, any knowledge, you will find entirely in this world. So at least this is the proof that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of God. Because there is no other parallel book like this Bhagavad Gita. Therefore, this Bhagavad Gita is accepted and adored by all classes of men and all over the world. Why not? Because Krishna claims that Bhuktaram-jabhita-vasam-sarvalokamaheswaram. Although Krishna appeared in India, he does not say that I am Indian. He says, sarvalokamaheswaram, the proprietor of the entire planet. Then again, one place in science, sarva-yonisu, the entire living species of life, and not only humankind. He says, aham bhujapadapita, I am the father, the entire living entity. So Krishna claims, because he is God, so he has to claim like that. He is not any particular country man or any particular society man. Krishna means all attractive. He is for everyone. Therefore he is Bhagavan. So here it is stated, Bhagavan, the personality of God is saying, answer. What he answered? Sannyasa karma yogasya nishresa karabhidhu. Tayasi karma sannyasa karma yoga vishishyate. Now, Krishna says that either you renounce the world, either be ill in the renounced order of life, just like we are in the renounced order of life. or you are in ordinary working capacity. That they are equally beneficial. But perhaps, but if we examine our neutral position, then Krishna recommends that better than the sannyas is to work. Is better. Perhaps karma sannyasa karma jiva vishishtate. This is a very nice point, try to understand. The sannyasi, just like we are sannyasi, according to our Vedic system, we are allowed to beg alms from the householder. The social system, the Varnasrama institution, is so made that the brahmachari, vanaprastha and the sannyasi and the grihastha. Grihastha is the householder. Now, the brahmachari is begged from the householder, the vanaprastha is begged from the householder, and the sannyasi also is begged from the householder. The householder is the only standing member who will feel all these three different status of social order. But in the Kali Yuga, in this age, some unscrupulous persons are taking advantage of this grace. Because this grace is not very costly, any kind of cotton cloth, you get 3 times worth and 2 cents worth from solar, and you get it orange color, and put on. Because in this age, nobody is inquiring whether he is actually a sannyasi or not, simply by grace. Of course, the grace is the best. Now, if you are taking advantage of this grace and the misuse in the position, that's what Krishna and the source that this will happen in future, because we are speaking this Bhagavad Gita 5,000 years before. So, as he is a key knowledge, entire knowledge, because he is God, he knows what is happening in the future. Therefore, he gives preference to working order than the sannyasa. Lord Chaitanya also, he also says that in this age, sannyas is not recommended. And if you question me, the Swamiji, why you have taken sannyas? You may ask a question. Yes. So I must tell you frankly that I had no desire to accept the sannyas. I never dreamt in my house. I was a householder. I never dreamt, but circumstantially I was forced to accept the sannyas grace just to become a preacher. That's a long history. But actually, personally, I was against accepting the sannyas, but I was forced somewhere or other to accept the sannyas. Of course, as far as possible, I am following the rules and regulations of the sannyasi as far as possible. So here, Krishna says, the sayasri karma, everything can be utilized for the ultimate goodness. Everything can be utilized, Krishna says. So there is no difference. Why there is no difference? If your ultimate goal is Krishna concept, then either to become Krishna concept in a grace of sannyasi or as an ordinary man, there is no difference. There is no difference. Because your aim is the same. Just like I give you one example, very nice example. In India, there are different graces of omen according to different positions. That is, in Tama Shastra, in Manusamhita, they are mentioned. Of course, now there is nobody following. Just like by grace, you can understand here is an old man who has got his husband, her husband at home. Here is an old man who has lost her husband. And here is an old man whose husband is out of home. Here is an old man who is prostitute. Simply by grace, one can understand. Because to address woman is difficult job, so society sanctions different grades. So according to that Vedic literature, when the husband is at home, a woman is recommended to dress herself very nice, very beautiful, just to enlighten the husband. The husband is serious. His wife nicely dressed and nicely, beautifully looking, then he takes her in turn. And similarly, a woman, when her husband is away from her, she should dress very meagerly, very meagerly. Now you find that the dress, at one time the woman is dressing meagerly, and at one time the woman is dressing very beautifully and nicely. But what is the purpose? The purpose is the husband. Similarly, if her purpose is Krishna consciousness, either I dress myself in this orange collar, or either you dress in coat, pant and shirt, oh, there is no question, there is no difference. There is no difference. Because the aim is the same. Everyone combined it. We have formed this society to work combined. There is no restriction that only the orange color sannyasi will be allowed in the sannyasi and not the white dress, a man in coat pants. No. That is not the purpose. If the purpose is that we have to become Krishna conscious, we have to work combined in Krishna consciousness, there is no question of changing the dress. Neither you have got to renounce your present position. There is another instance in Bengali poetry. Griheba manete thake sagarimanga bole dake. That a man may be situated as a householder, or a man may be situated as a renounced or a lord. That doesn't matter. If he is attached with Krishna consciousness, he is the perfect man. So here is the indication. Though you are asking what is the difference between the Karma Yoga and Sannyas. So there is no such difference. Because if you become a karma yogi, karma yogi means you simply work for Krishna, then you are better than a sannyasi. Because a sannyasi is living at the expense of the society. But a man is fully aware that whatever I am earning and whatever I am doing, it is all meant for Krishna. He is a practical man. He is a practical man. That's why Arjuna was not a sannyasi. After hearing Bhagavad Gita, he did not take up the renounced order of life and dress himself in orange colored dress and went there. Down the back is his law. He remained the same man, the same military man, but he became the most perfect Krishna consciousness. The same principle is there. Therefore, yes, Lord Krishna says, sannyasa karma yogasya nishesa parabhu. Either you take sannyasa all you remain in your position. That doesn't matter. You can attain the highest perfection from any position, provided you are Krishna conscious. Jaya Samitta Sannyasi, Jona Deshti Makan Sati. Yes, how nicely Krishna says. Jaya Samitta Sannyasi. Just try to understand that consciousness is always a sannyasi. Not by death, but by his actual activity. What? Na Deshti Makan Sati. He does not and they hate anything, and he does not desire this quality. He does not hate anything, and he does not desire anything. Suppose I am working. Suppose I am washing dishes. That doesn't matter. I do not hate. Of course, in your country, it is very flattering. But you can accept any kind of work. It's very the same thing is confirmed. There is no question of hating any work. Dignity or labor is all right. No deshti, no kaṁkhati. But after working the result, he does not care. Suppose by doing some lower class of work, I get some profit. If that is engaged in Krishna consciousness, then I am because I don't say, but I offer the result to Krishna.
Just take the example of Arjuna, all of in the beginning, he was hating, fighting.
He was hating. I cannot fight. This fighting is with my kinsmen, it is not possible. I am not. He was hating. But when he understood Bhagavad Gita, he took up that fighting. He gave up his hating. But the reason, Nakam Kshati, he never desired the reason. Krishna ordered to fight. He thought, that's it. This is real surrender. That he does not act for his own account. For his sense gratification, but he was. Never mind, he does not hate anyone. Any sort of work I am prepared to do, and the result I have to offer to Krishna. This is called real sannyasa. So Krishna and this is Vyasa Nishta Sannyasa. Nishta means eternally. Not for the time, eternally. Nishta Sannyasa, Jiva Deshti. He does not hate any kind of war, but Nakam Kshati, he does not desire also for enjoying the reason. Nidbanda hi Mahabhaha, Sikham Bandha Pramichyate. That sort of sannyasi, he is always happy and he is a liberated person. He is a liberated person. I think next we shall talk and make him. If you have got any questions, the summary is that if you want Krishna consciousness without any hate and only for Krishna study, that is the highest perfection of Krishna. That is the highest perfection of Krishna.